a triangle placed upon another triangle fits exactly with it, then the two triangles are congruent. If triangle ABC and triangle PQR are congruent, under the correspondence of vertices, A corresponds to P, B corresponds to Q, and C corresponds to R, that is, ABC corresponds to PQR, then symbolically it is written as triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Note that while examining the congruence of two triangles, we have to write their angles and sides in a specific order, that is, with a specific one-to-one correspondence of the vertices. If triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, in the correspondence ABC corresponds to PQR, then we get the following six congruences, namely, angle A is congruent to angle P, angle B is congruent to angle Q, angle C is congruent to angle R, segment AB is congruent to segment PQ, segment BC is congruent to segment QR, segment AC is congruent to segment PR. Two triangles are congruent if all the sides and all the angles of one triangle are congruent to the corresponding sides and angles of the other triangle. To show that a pair of triangles is congruent, it is not necessary to show that all six corresponding parts of the two triangles are congruent. If three specific parts of one triangle are respectively congruent with the three corresponding parts of the other, then the remaining three corresponding parts are also congruent with each other. It means the specific three parts ascertain the test of congruence. This is very important, so I am repeating. Listen. If three specific parts of one triangle are respectively congruent with the three corresponding parts of the other, then the remaining three corresponding parts are also congruent with each other. It means the specific three parts ascertain the test of congruence. Here, parts means sides or angles. If three specific parts of one triangle are respectively congruent with the three corresponding parts of the other, then the remaining three corresponding parts are also congruent with each other. It means the specific three parts ascertain the test of congruence. SAS test. If two sides and the included angle of a triangle are congruent with two corresponding sides and the included angle of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Now look at the figure and then you can learn the test, SAS test, by looking at the figure. Now in this figure, for the correspondence ABC corresponding to XYZ, that means the vertex correspondence of the vertices are taken now. For the correspondence ABC corresponding to XYZ, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle XYZ. If two sides and an included angle of a triangle are congruent with two corresponding sides and the included angle of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Here, triangle ABC and triangle XYZ are taken for example. You can see the two sides AB and BC marked. AB is in equal measure to XY of the other triangle, the other corresponding triangle. You have to consider the correspondence of the vertices. Here, there are six correspondence of the vertices. six different ways of writing the correspondence of the vertices. Here only one correspondence is taken. Vertex A is corresponding to X, vertex B is corresponding to Y, and vertex C is corresponding to Z is written as ABC corresponds to XYZ. So under this correspondence, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle XYZ because of the SAS test. What the SAS test is telling? If two sides and the included angle of a triangle, for example, you are taking triangle ABC. Which are the two sides marked here? AB and BC. What is the included angle? The angle between the two sides is called the included angle. Here angle ABC is the included angle. Otherwise, it is called angle B. So now, for the other triangle, corresponding sides and the included angle have to be taken. Corresponding sides will be according to the correspondence of the vertices. A corresponds to X, B corresponds to Y, and C corresponds to Z here. So, side AB corresponds to side XY. Side BC corresponds to side YZ. And angle ABC will correspond to angle XYZ. And according to the SAS test, these will be congruent to each other. That is, side AB will be congruent to side XY. Side BC is congruent to side YZ. And angle B is congruent to angle Y. Because the two triangles are congruent. In the figure, it is marked that two sides and the included angle of a triangle are congruent with two corresponding sides and the included angle of the other triangle, that is XYZ, triangle XYZ. Then the triangles are congruent with each other. Then we can say that triangles are congruent with each other. When the triangles are congruent with each other, then we can say segment AB is congruent to segment XY, segment BC is congruent to segment YZ, and angle ABC is congruent to angle XYZ here. And the remaining parts of the triangle also will be congruent. What are the remaining parts? It is enough to show with three paths. But now, the remaining parts also will be congruent to each other. That is, side AC will be congruent to side XZ. Angle C will be congruent to angle Z. And angle A also will be congruent to angle X. Now, coming to SSS test. SSS test for congruence of triangles. If three sides of a triangle are congruent with three corresponding sides of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Now here also we are taking the correspondence of the vertices to be A corresponding to P, B corresponding to Q, and C corresponding to R. That is otherwise written as ABC corresponds to PQR. For this particular correspondence, out of the six correspondence pairs of correspondence, we are taking only one correspondence for explaining this figure. Now, for the correspondence ABC corresponds to PQR, now triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Why? Because of the SSS test. Here the three sides of the first triangle, that is side AB, side BC and side AC are respectively congruent to side PQ, side QR and side PR respectively. Now here, side AB is congruent to side PQ is given in the figure. Side BC is congruent to side QR and side AC is congruent to side PR. If three sides of the triangle are congruent with three corresponding sides of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Now, for the correspondence of the vertices A corresponding to P, B corresponding to Q and C corresponding to R, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR because of the SSS test. Now, how to find out the remaining congruent parts? Looking at the correspondence of the vertices, we can find out the remaining congruent parts. That is, angle A will be congruent to angle P, angle B will be congruent to angle Q, and angle C also will be congruent to angle R. Now coming to ASA test. ASA test for congruence of triangles. If two angles of a triangle and a side included by them are congruent with two corresponding angles and the side included by them of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Now look at these two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle DEF. If two angles of a triangle and a side included by them, see, you can see angle ABC and angle ACB marked in the figure, and side BC is also marked. But what is side BC here? Side BC is the included side of those two angles. The angles are ABC and ACB. Otherwise, we can say angle B and angle C. In between angle B and angle C, that side is otherwise called the included side. The side BC is called the included side. Similarly, for triangle DEF, we have angle E marked, angle F is marked, and the side between these two angles, that is the side EF, is also marked. So if two angles of a triangle and a side included by them are congruent, that is, if you consider triangle ABC, you can see two angles of the triangle and a side included by them is said to be congruent with the two corresponding angles and the side included by them of the other triangle. That means they are saying the triangles are congruent with each other. Here, angle B is congruent to angle E, is marked in the figure. Side BC is congruent to side EF, and angle C is congruent to angle F. The side is the included side between the two angles. So only we are calling this test as angle side angle test. That is otherwise ASA test. So now, in between the two angles, we have the side. So it is called the included side. If two angles of a triangle, first triangle we are taking as triangle ABC. So if two angles of triangle ABC and a side included by them, that is side BC, are congruent with the two corresponding angles of the other triangle as well as the side included by them of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Angle B is congruent to angle E, because we have to do it according to the correspondence of the vertices. You are given ABC corresponds to DEF. That means vertex A is corresponding to vertex D, vertex B is corresponding to vertex E, vertex C is corresponding to vertex F. You have to see one triangle's vertex with the other triangle, correspondence with the other triangle's vertex. Don't do of the same triangle, it will become wrong. For the correspondence, ABC corresponds to DEF. That means vertex A corresponds to vertex D, vertex B corresponds to vertex E, and vertex C corresponds to vertex F. So for this correspondence, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF because of the ASA test. So once again, I am reading this test. If two angles of a triangle and a side included by them are congruent with two corresponding angles and the side included by them of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. For the correspondence ABC corresponding to DEF, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. Similarly, you should be able to do for all other correspondence. There are six correspondence of the vertices of this triangle. Two triangles we need to take, ABC and DEF. There will be six ways of writing the correspondence. So, you have, whenever you are given some correspondence of the vertices, you should be able to do accordingly. According to the correspondence of the vertices only, we can write the remaining parts of the triangle which are congruent. For example, here, whatever is missing will be the remaining congruent parts. These two triangles are congruent, we have found out. So now the remaining congruent parts will be whatever is missing. Here two sides markings are missing and one angle's marking is missing. So now if you take ABC, only BC is marked. Now what are the remaining sides? AB as well as AC. So first you take side AB. Side AB will be congruent to side DE because of the correspondence of the vertices. A corresponds to D and B corresponds to E. So side AB will be congruent to side DE. Then side AC, what will be other remaining congruent part? Side AC, it will be congruent to side DF because according to the correspondence of the vertices here, what is given? A corresponds to D and C corresponds to F. Then coming to the angles, coming to triangle ABC, you can see angle B marked as well as angle C marked in the figure. What is left out? Angle A is left out. So now coming to angle A. Angle A will be congruent to angle D because the correspondence of the vertices is A corresponds to D. So the remaining congruent parts of these two triangles can be written. Now coming to SAA test. Side angle angle test. Otherwise it is called AAS test also. Nowadays in new notebooks, textbooks, they are printing that way also. SAA test, otherwise AAA test, AAS test. So you should know if somebody is telling you AAS test, it is same as SAA test. Now, if two angles of a triangle and a side not included by them are congruent with corresponding angles and a corresponding side not included by them of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Many of you go wrong with SAA test because the side there is not included between the two angles. So now consider angle A and angle C of the first triangle ABC. You can see the marking of the side which is not included between the two angles. It is separate. See, BC is marked. BC is marked. Then the angles are angle A and angle C. AC is not marked. AC is the included side between the two angles. So if such a case is there, sometimes AB may be marked and angle A and angle C will be given, then also we have to apply SAA test only. So now if two angles of a triangle and a side not included by them are congruent with corresponding angles and a corresponding side not included by them of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. So in triangle RST, you can see ST marked. But the included side will be RT here. Included, we are considering the side not included by them, by the angles for this test. So we will not show any marking on RT. We can show marking on ST, otherwise we can show the marking on RS. Then also it will be SAA test only. If AB is marked in the previous figure, if AB is marked and angle A and angle C are marked in the first figure, similarly in the second figure, if RS is marked and angle R and angle T are marked, then also it is SAA test only because that side will not become the included side between the two angles. Now the angles are angle A and angle C, which are marked in the first figure, and the side which is considered is side BC in the first figure, which is a side not included by the angles. Now, according to the SAA test, if two angles of a triangle and a side not included by them are congruent with corresponding angles and a corresponding side not included by them of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Now, here we are considering the correspondence of the vertices. A corresponds to R, B corresponds to S, and C corresponds to T, which is otherwise written as ABC corresponds to RST. For the correspondence ABC corresponds to RST, here these two triangles are congruent. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle RST because of the SAA test. So what the SAA test is telling, if two angles of a triangle and a side not included by them are congruent with corresponding angles and a corresponding side not included by them of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Here in triangles ABC and RST, angle A is congruent to angle R, angle C is congruent to angle T, and side BC is congruent to side ST. You can also say segment BC is congruent to segment ST. Now segment BC and segment ST are not included by the angles. So we can apply the SAA test here. So for the correspondence ABC corresponding to RST, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle RST. Now let us consider what are the remaining congruent parts of the triangles. Now what is missing? The remaining sides AB and AC are missing. BC is only marked, AB is not marked, AC is not marked. For the other triangle, RS is not marked and RT is not marked. So for the remaining pairs of the congruent parts, we can say segment AB is congruent to segment RS. We have to look at the correspondence of the vertices and say segment AB is congruent to segment RS because A corresponds to R and B corresponds to S according to the given correspondence of the vertices. Otherwise, you will go wrong. Segment AB is congruent to segment RS and segment AC will be congruent to segment RT because A corresponds to R and C corresponds to T according to the given correspondence of the vertices. Now, coming to the angle. Angle A is marked, angle C is marked, but angle C is not marked. Here, angle R is marked, angle T is marked in the figure, angle S is not marked in the figure. So, the remaining congruent part in that, one of the pairs will be these two angles which are congruent. Angle B is congruent to angle S. Otherwise, you can write angle ABC is congruent to angle RST. If you are using three letter names, you can write angle ABC is congruent to angle RST. If you are using a single letter, then you can write angle B is congruent to angle S. So these are the remaining congruent parts of these two triangles. Now coming to the hypotenuse side test for congruence of triangles. We are taking two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle UVW, which are right angle triangles. You can see the marking there of right angle. That is, measure of angle ABC is 90 degrees. Also measure of angle UVW is 90 degrees. That says that these two triangles are right angle triangles. Since the measures are 90 degrees for each of these triangles, one measure becomes 90 degrees. See, measure of angle B is 90 degrees of the first triangle. Measure of angle V is 90 degrees of the second triangle. So triangle ABC is a right angle triangle and triangle UVW is a right angle triangle. For the right angle triangle, the side opposite in 90 degrees is called the hypotenuse. So here in triangle ABC, AC is the hypotenuse. In triangle UVW, UW is the hypotenuse. So if the hypotenuse and the side of a right angle triangle are congruent with the hypotenuse and the corresponding side of the other right angle triangle, then the two triangles are congruent with each other. You can see the markings. The first triangle, triangle ABC, side AB is marked and side AC is marked. The second triangle, side UV is marked and the side UW is marked. That is the hypotenuse. Now here, in the first triangle, you can see AB marked. Now look at the correspondence of the vertices. ABC is corresponding to U, V, W is given in the question. So A corresponds to U, B corresponds to V, and C corresponds to W. Now accordingly you have to see. Now AB is, segment AB is marked to be congruent to segment UV. Segment AC, which is the hypotenuse of the first triangle, is marked congruent to the hypotenuse of the second triangle, which is UW. And angle B is congruent to angle V is understandable because each is of 90 degrees. The measure of each of the angles is 90 degrees. That is, measure of angle B is 90 degrees and measure of angle V is also 90 degrees. So these two triangles, angles are congruent to each other. Angle B is congruent to angle V is understandable. So here for hypotenuse side test, we need to consider only the hypotenuse as well as any one of the sides to be congruent to the hypotenuse of the other triangle and the any one of the sides of the other triangle. But you have to consider the correspondence of the vertices also when you are doing this. So if a hypotenuse and a side of a right angle triangle are congruent with the hypotenuse and the corresponding side, that's why we are saying corresponding side of the other right angle triangle, that means we have to consider the correspondence of the vertices and do it. If the hypotenuse and a side of a right angle triangle are congruent with the hypotenuse and the corresponding side of the other right angle triangle, then the two triangles are congruent with each other. So for the correspondence, ABC, which is corresponding to UVW, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle UVW. Now, what are the remaining corresponding parts of this, these two triangles? Already ABC is marked as 90 degrees, so we should not consider this as the remaining congruent part. So the remaining congruent part, what are the remaining angles? Angle A is congruent to angle U. Looking at the correspondence of the vertices, you have to say angle C is congruent to angle W. Then which side is marking is missing? BC is missing. So segment BC is congruent to segment BW. According to the correspondence of the vertices, B corresponds to V and C corresponds to W. So segment BC is congruent to segment VW. So these are the remaining congruent parts of the of these two triangles. A is congruent to angle A is congruent to angle U, angle C is congruent to angle W, and side BC is congruent to side VW. Otherwise, segment BC is congruent to segment VW will be the remaining congruent parts of these two triangles. Now, so you might have understood what is hypotenuse side test.